Hey guys, Logan here. The Battlefield 2042 beta was really fun, but of course it had its problems. But recently we got a lot of things confirmed by DICE developers on Twitter and Reddit. Things that already been fixed and tweaked for the full game release. So today I want to let you all know about these things and in the progress hopefully answer some of the things you are wondering about. Starting with news on the ledge grabbing. In the beta, players might have noticed that you could not grab ledges that were placed higher than yourself and pull yourself over. Confirmed by DICE core gameplay designer Drunksy, the ledge grabbing is coming in the full release of the game, meaning that you could be able to grab the ledge over your own head and pull yourself up in the full game. Great feature. And level designer Kalle Nyström did confirm that the full game will feature more tanks per team on the map Orbital. In the beta there were only 2 tanks per team, now that's been doubled to 4 tanks per team. That means a total of 8 tanks on the map. We also got several things confirmed by core gameplay designer Niels Stolinga, sorry if I butchered your name there, but mostly about physics and gameplay. Starting with the animations for getting into vehicles, that have been shortened and the exit animation are pretty much gone. I barely noticed the entering animation in the beta, and in the full game, it's even shorter. The jump spamming has been addressed for the full game, so that's not something that players can exploit once the full game releases. And in the beta, there were pretty much zero customization besides the plus system for the weapons, but vehicles had none. But in the full game, you will have access to the customization in the menu and in-game. So I guess that you can put together your own loadouts and stuff like that. There are some strafe inputs added to the sliding mechanic. In the beta, players could only slide in a straight line, but this has changed up a bit, meaning that you can use strafe at the same time as you're sliding, I guess. I love how sliding mechanics worked in the beta, so having more freedom with it is great. Battlefield 5 introduced a feature called combat roll. This was a way of not taking damage when falling from some heights. This feature is not planned to make a return in Battlefield 2042. Some boost to the vaulting onto moving objects have been made for the full game, because besides vehicles, there are big moving things on the maps and players are going to be able to vault onto these things, so that sounds cool. And fixes for the FPS drop when using scopes, and the weird bugs when using the grappling hook, and the bugged elevators have also been fixed for the full game. These are some great fixes and it's important that the community get to know this. I know many people that played the beta and made up their mind about what to think of the game. That's not good because the beta build was several months old and was missing a lot of things. I ask you to help here. Help me share this video to let people know that the full game is so much better than the old beta we got to play. But that's all for today. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching, subscribe for more, and hit that like if you enjoyed the video. Hope to see you in my next one. This is Logan, signing out.